Good morning, everyone. Today is extremely exciting because we are leaving Daytona and we are going to the beach club. Me and mom are both extremely excited. We've never stayed there before. It's like super fancy to us. We are extremely, extremely excited. Before that though, we do need to get breakfast. It's about like 6:22 in the morning right now, so it is pretty early and I did not sleep too great last night, so I'm kind of tired. But we are going to Denny's again because it's open 24 hours and it's right across the street, and we have enjoyed the food there every time we have gone, so we are going again for breakfast. It is still kind of dark out, which is fine, like all the street lights and that are still on, so pretty early. However, it's not windy right now, which is I think the first time we've ever walked out here and it not be really windy, which is nice. We got all-you-can-eat pancakes for $4 a piece, and they look delicious. And we are off, guys. I'm driving, so mom might film a little bit for me. We're headed off to the beach club, about an hour and a half, 2 hour drive-ish. It shouldn't be too bad. I'm gonna drive though because I need to get used to the Florida roads, because I have never really driven on them before except for like the last couple of days. So I really need to get used to them in this car, because this isn't necessarily the car I drive all the time at home either. So just getting used to them and how people drive down here and stuff, as well as the speedometer, because mine's in kilometers, we're down here it's miles. So there's a couple things I just need to get used to, so that's why I'm gonna drive this. But we're hoping to arrive there. We're leaving earlier than we thought, so we're leaving 15 minutes earlier than we thought. It's 7:45. We're hoping to leave by 8, so hoping we'll get there a little bit earlier than that and then enjoy the pool. Gate told us to go over the bridge and just like go check in, and so that's what we were doing. And we got right to the front and we were like about to walk in, and this valet guy goes, give me your keys. So, and we're like, we don't want valet. And then he tells us we have to come all the way back here and park in self park even though we're not even checked in yet. I don't know, I've never seen that happen at a Disney resort before. So now we have to go all the way, walk all the way just to come back in like 5 minutes to take all our stuff and walk all the way back instead of just like checking in for the 5 minutes. So kind of annoying, but we're here. Let's go. We're all checked in, our room is ready. We did not think that was gonna happen, so super exciting. We got our magic bands on, we're up on the fourth floor. Yeah, we're gonna go get our stuff. The check-in process was super sweet, super easy, and yeah, everything is ready to go. This is going so well so far. Just look at how pretty this place is. It is absolutely gorgeous. Okay, here we are in our room. So this here is the little mini fridge that we have. A cups, cute picture of Mickey and Minnie, big closet. This is the beautiful vanity area and the little shower, which is also so cute. And look at the little Mickeys on the curtains. And then this is the main part of our room. It is gorgeous. They have the little hours thing playing on the TV. There's a nice desk and chair. And we have a balcony, which doesn't look out on anything special necessarily, but we have it, and door opens and you can go outside, and it's very nice. It is very warm, but it is very pretty. Okay guys, so as you guys saw from the title, you're probably wondering how we got this resort for free, because this resort, the beach club, is usually super, super expensive and it costs a lot to stay here. But one cool thing that you can do with Disney Resort hotels is you can actually book them through hotels.com. I am by no means sponsored. If hotels.com wants to sponsor me, come ahead. However, I am not sponsored. This is not a sponsored video. But what we did last year when we stayed at the Swan and Dolphin was we booked through hotels.com because it was cheaper. And what happens when you stay 10 nights through hotels.com is you get one night free at the approximate value of those first 10 nights. So this was a little bit more. We ended up paying, I believe, around $200 for this heavily discounted room. But if you are staying at a resort that is approximately beach club price, you can pay next to nothing once you get your 10th night free, or the room just might be free altogether. So that's why we are able to stay here tonight, is because we got an amazing, amazing discount on this room. We're gonna go enjoy the pool today. It is gonna be lovely. We are heading out to the pool, sand bottom pool, so cool. Never been in it before. It's only for the beach club guests, like you can't go in any otherwise, and yacht club. So very exciting to check it out. Here it is. I'll do a full lap for you guys once we kind of find a place to sit. The love bugs are everywhere. They are so gross. But we found some chairs here. It's kind of confusing, the layout here actually. And I'll just give you guys a little tour. So over there is where you enter and where the slide comes out. And then over there's the exit to the slide if you want to get up there. And then this is the shallower-ish area. Like there is all sand. You can kind of see it in the bottom there. And then it actually goes all the way up there too. And there's a bunch of chairs and stuff up there. So then over here, it just like kind of leads over. And then there's the little like volleyball net court. And you can swim like under the bridge and stuff. And it's about 5 feet over there. There's also little like waterfalls you can see underneath. And then this here is not attached to the actual pool. This is the lazy river, which is also all sand bottom. And this actually gets down to 8 feet. So it's actually really, really deep. So that's kind of cool as well. And then there's the giant like pinwheel here and bridge to go back over and stuff too. There's lots of people in the lazy river now. And that there is the Browner building is actually the yacht club. And this here is the pool bar. This is also a little kiddie area. There's a ton of like sand all over and they can build sand castles and stuff too. We came back up to the room quick because I had to change my bathing suit top and we wanted money. We're gonna get some drinks. But it literally broke. Like I kind of bent over to grab something out of my bag and the back, just like the little clasp thing, just like completely broke. It was plastic. There is no fixing it. So that was great. And so I'm just put this one on with the black bottoms again, but cool. These look so good. So I got a storm chaser, I think that's what it was called, and mom got a peanut calava, and they are super delicious. They were 25 bucks for the two of them, so 11 something each. So there's lightning outside, they closed the pool, they closed the deck, we're kind of just wandering around now, just kind of looking around. So we're on the second floor, and here's a little view of the lobby. Super pretty, super cool, kind of full right now because of the rain. It's not raining yet, but it will soon. And then down like right on the other side of that staircase is where Kate May is. This is where you enter into the villas. There's a ton of tables on the outside. It's right outside of the gift shop inside. Very, very pretty. You can see the black cloud up there though. They also have, for the vacation club, all the resorts have a little like symbolic thing, and this one here has Ariel, which I like this statue. I think it's really pretty and kind of cool. So we're just gonna walk in, look at the lobby of the actual villas. It's very pretty. It's like a pool table in there, it looks like. It's ice water down there. And this here is like the main little sitting area. A big picture up there. All the stuff on the little shelves. This is the villa pool here. Nothing too big or too special, but it's a lot calmer and chiller than the other one for sure. Nice little picnic table out here too if you want a little meal. Oh yeah, there's a little barbecue as well. You can cook something up. He's just a baby. Look at him. He's so tiny. We're back in the lobby, this time at like normal floor level. And then just down the hall from the lobby is where the gift shop is. And this is also a really, really cool gift shop that I love. And it's called the Marketplace. Got all the new ones. So these are in replace of the rose gold now. They no longer sell the rose gold. These are something, the briar rose ones or something. Not sure. Oh, I guess, no, these are the briar rose ones. Those are just cask ones. So additionally with the gift shop, this is also their quick service area too.
Still aren't letting people in the pool. There is a literal lineup to get in. We are not waiting in that. We're just going for that to go down because there's more than enough room for everyone in there.
But we thought while we are waiting, we'd just take a little walk down to the beachy area. Sand is nice and white. I love the beach down here. It does get really, really hot though during the day, so you gotta be careful because it burns you. Found some chairs in the shade here and just looking out at the boardwalk, and you can see the boat coming in. I love this area of Disney World. It's super pretty and always just super, super peaceful. We are back in business, guys. Looking nice out again. The sky is blue. Dinner. It is about 7:15 right now. We have dinner reservations at 6:55 downstairs at Cape May. Never eaten there for dinner before. Loved breakfast there so much. I'm just wearing the same outfit as before with my ears. These are the Yacht Club ears, but I think they look cute for the Beach Club too. They're from NorthernNeverland. You guys can use code Brooke10 if you did want a discount off NorthernNeverland ears. I will link them down below. That discount is just for you guys to use if you want to save money. I don't make money off that code, and I will never send you guys towards something that I do not believe in. So I believe in these ears, and if you are interested in them by any chance, this is just a way to save money. It is supposed to be a seafood buffet tonight, and I am so hungry. We haven't eaten since those pancakes this morning at Denny's, so wow. And we're gonna go downstairs, fill ourselves up, and then I probably won't eat a lot again, honestly. We have like muffins for tomorrow for breakfast, but after that I won't eat again until we have trails and dinner tomorrow night. So overall, not a ton. I will show you guys a little bit around the little hallway at the hotel though as we're walking down. So there are the little starfish sea things. There we go. So you can see there's like a hidden Mickey in the carpet. There's also this adorable little seating area in the middle of the hallway. So we checked in. They're gonna text us when it's ready. It's about 10 minutes or so, probably. Got a little bit of sun today, not too bad. But it smells really good from here. We can see it from here. It seems like it's really delicious. You guys can see the whole buffet area from here. Okay, let's eat some food. We have to find plates first. But this looks delicious. This is all the pastas, I think, and the crab legs. These look so good. Those look really good. So this is the first plate, and I only got through half of the buffet. Plate number two. On this side, they have fruits. They have big jumbo shrimp. They have different type of crab leg. I got some cheese, your classic like chicken, mashed potatoes, and some more fish. I believe there's salmon down there too. So I just got some watermelon. I'll get more fruit later. Salmon, this weird crab leg, which I'm not sure about, and then like the normal crab legs as well.
I've never personally tried crab legs before, and they are.
Next plate, a little bit of fruit. First of two different dessert tables. They have cute little Mother's Day cupcakes because it's Mother's Day today. There's a whole bunch of different ones actually. Then cookies with like worms and dirt, brownies. Wow. At this one here, they also have a whole bunch of stuff and a cheesecake, which I am very excited for. So I got cheesecake. So excited for my cheesecake. I got this little Mickey thing. It was just shaped like Mickey, so I decided to get it. Little piece of chocolate cake and a little Mother's Day cupcake because apparently I am a mother, because that's what the guy told me at the pool today. He told me happy Mother's Day. So I'm gonna take a Mother's Day cupcake for that. And I got two more cheesecake because I was very deprived yesterday. Okay, we're done dinner. That was delicious.
Amazing.
Amazing. Out of 10, like 12. That was so good. We're so full. I feel like I actually got my money's worth out of it too. It was $52 a person, I think.
$52.95.
It was $110 for both of us. So it was expensive. It is definitely more expensive. But like the crab legs and stuff, crab is expensive, and a lot of that, like seafood and that, is expensive. So that's what you're gonna pay for. And we definitely are full. I had 5 plates, I think. And you had the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Which is not like you.
I usually have like two. Yeah, so definitely got my money's worth out of it. So full. We've decided, it's 8 o'clock now. We have decided that we're going to kind of do a loop and then go watch the Epcot fireworks from the gates, actually. We kind of need to wear off a little bit of this food, but it was just delicious. Like, would definitely do that again. The focus is so weird on this camera. gondolas. This is, I believe, where the station is gonna be. They're almost done setting it up, I believe.
So this is where we are gonna be watching the fireworks. We are just outside of Epcot. That's like a wall right there, and then like the other side of that wall is Epcot, and you can kind of see France. Which direction? I think it's like right there-ish. So very close. We'll definitely be able to hear the music and see most of the fireworks. As we wait for the fireworks, there are about 10 minutes or so left. I think I'm going to live stream them on Instagram instead of filming them. So if you haven't already, go check out my Instagram. The username is right here, because I will be live streaming hopefully all the time in the parks. I also post on my story all the time and photos, keeping up to date. These vlogs are a little bit delayed, obviously, because I have to edit them. But if you guys want to see what's happening in real time, make sure you go follow me and check that out. Guys, the fireworks just ended and I'm currently just on the live stream right now. Just kind of talking to people. We didn't see too many like from there, just because it was like kind of difficult, but we saw most of them, so that was pretty cool. Just not a lot of the music we couldn't hear. So me and Mom were actually just talking about one cool thing that I realized, and that is that today is the 30th daily video. So filming this is the 30th video I filmed. When I'm posting it, it'll be the 30th video, which is crazy. That means I've been doing daily videos for a month now. I really have no plans on stopping. I think it's really cool. I may go down to every other day depending how work goes and training and all my shifts and that. We'll see. But at this point, I just want to keep posting as much as possible every day for you guys. If you are enjoying them, let me know in the comments below. Or let me know if you want me to do every other day, if that's better for you guys, or let me know. Or also leave down below suggestions of things that you want to see in the parks, new stuff you want me to look at, because I'm really not aware of a lot of stuff that's going on. So anything new, anything exciting, anything you just want to rides you want me to check out, anything like that. It's pretty empty at night. So one really cool thing about this pool is there are actually these like whirlpool jets. So they spin you around in a circle and it just kind of like circulates you. You can just go like around and around and around just by floating. Then it's also, right now it's concrete, but there is a lot of sand in the bottom of this pool as well. It's all crazy sand bottom, which is super, super neat. So I'm just working my way out right now. We're kind of gonna go on the water slide, I think, but yeah, super cool. And that is it for the pool. We're just drying off. We're gonna head back upstairs.
One last look at the area at nighttime. Very pretty, would love to come back one day. The guy in the elevator told us apparently there's a ton of cop cars out front and no one knows before. You can see one leaving right now, but we can't. Oh, there's two more coming in. You can see Epcot from here. I just realized that. Oh, yeah. The ball, you can actually see it from here. Did not realize, that's kind of cool. Theme park view, just cut down that tree, please.
Okay, so from here is where we're actually gonna call it a night. I need to edit this because I don't even know what's happening tomorrow. I am checking in to my DCP. What? Time has flown by so, so quickly. I need a shower tonight still. It's like probably like, I don't know, 9 o'clock maybe? No, after 9, it's probably closer to 10 now. But I'm checking in for my DCP. I need to pack up my stuff. I need to unpack tomorrow. Tomorrow is just gonna be a crazy day and I am vlogging all of it for you guys. In fact, I am vlogging this next entire week. I am currently posting daily videos every single day if you do not know, so make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Go check them out. Give this video a thumbs up if you did like it. I absolutely loved our stay at the beach club. I am so, so happy we decided to come here. It has been an absolutely amazing day. Could not have asked for a better one. So I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog as much as I enjoyed filming it. But thank you again so much for watching. I will see you guys tomorrow and have a magical rest of your day.